Hey everyone, Kyle Bascombe here. Today we're going to be doing an oil change on a 2015 C300. It's going to be your W205 chassis, but this oil change is also going to be applicable to just about anything that has the M274 2-liter turbo engine. So we're talking about a C300, E300, like your GLC 300, those models from 15 model year up to the present in some cases. Today we're gonna be using the CTA oil extractor to do the job. So we're just gonna do everything from above. However, I am gonna lift the vehicle and show you exactly what you need to do if you intend to do a more traditional oil change with a jack under the vehicle. All right, so if you do not have an extractor and you need to use gravity to get the oil out of the system under the car, you're going to have 7 8-millimeter sheet metal screws that hold the pan in place, the engine splash shield or belly pan shield. Once you remove those, you're going to have a 13-millimeter bolt for the oil drain. So as long as you have a 13-millimeter and an 8-millimeter for the splash shield, you're going to be able to do the job under the car. In order to complete the job, you are going to need an OE oil filter. Today we're going to be using the filter from Hengst. We have our 5W40 LIQUI MOLY. We love LIQUI MOLY products in Mercedes vehicles. That's what we're going to be using today. And you really only need one other tool if you're going to use the oil extraction method, and that is a 27-millimeter, preferably a deep socket. All right, so in order to do this oil change, you want to start by removing the cosmetic cover. It's just held on by a couple of clips. So just a little bit of force and it'll come right out. Next thing we need to do is gain access to the oil filter housing. So we're going to remove this air snorkel. Normally there is a clip here where it's retained to the body and you turn it and it comes out. Unfortunately, someone got in here in the past and just kind of broke it. So we're gonna skip that step. Start by removing the snorkel in this area. I like to push it in a little bit first and then pull it out. It's just clipped in. Same for the other side, just push in, squeeze, and then pull it out. All right, now we've got more than enough room to get to the oil filter housing. On this application, it's at a little bit of an angle. So what I like to do, just come in here with a dirty rag, because as you're pulling it out, sometimes there's going to be oil in the cap portion towards the top of the filter housing. When you pull it out, oil's gonna end up everywhere you don't want it to be. So this is the 27 mil deep socket. I've got like a 2-3 inch extension here just to give me a little more space to work around the charge pipe hose. And we're just gonna break that free. So as you spin it off, just watch the lip between the plastic filter housing and the metal. You're just basically looking to see if there's any oil that's seeping. All right, so there's basically no more resistance, so we'll get this ratchet out of the way, and that way I can control things a little bit better by hand. Just pulling up slowly and then angling it towards the front of the car to clear everything. And we're out. This filter housing cap has your oil filter, which just pops up like this, and you've got three O-rings, one at the base, one here and here. So I'm going to remove the filter and I'll show you how to remove the O-rings next. One of the first things we noticed is the smell of fuel in the oil. It's normally indicative of a lot of like really short trips. Oil's not getting all the way up to temperature. That's probably the case with this car here. In order to remove the O-rings, I just like to pinch the tip and then slide it over the top. If I have any trouble removing it, I'll get a pick in there and that helps you get it out. That's what we're gonna do here. So I've pinched it, that gives me a little bit of room to work. I just get in there with the pick and then wedge it out and throw it in the engine bay. You definitely wanna do that. So I'm gonna do the same thing again. I'm pinching to get a little more room to get the pick in. There we are. Just a little pressure and it's out. This time I've got my index finger on it so it doesn't go flying. All right, and then for the last one, may not even need a pick. Now I'm going to use the pick here as well. A little bit different. I'm just using a straight pick this time. Just going around the housing. Just rolls right off. All right, so we're going to put the new O-rings on now. You're either going to use fresh oil, or sometimes I'll just put my finger right into the filter housing cap and just kind of dress the O-ring with some of the oil. And then we're going to slide it back into its home. And you're getting it into that bottom landing. So we're just going to roll it a little bit more gently. And now it's in the landing. We've got two more O-rings. I'm just dipping my finger into the filter housing to get a little bit of oil to dress the O-ring. And then I don't know if you guys can see what I'm doing, but I'm just rolling it down until it reaches this land right there. And we've got one more. Just dress it first. And now it's going on that land. All right, so we've got our three O-rings on there. Last thing we want to do is take the filter, slide it all the way down until you hear it click, and then we can put it back into the filter housing. Just screwing it in by hand first until I feel some resistance, and then I'll get the 27 mil socket in there with the ratchet. You want to be mindful that the housing cover is plastic, so we're not going to be using a lot of torque. Once I feel the land hit, I'm probably just going to go another 5 degrees, and that's it. The actual torque spec is marked on the filter housing. I believe it's 25 newton meters, but we'll verify in a moment. So what you'll notice is directly on the filter housing, and this is the case for a lot of Mercedes applications, your torque specification is going to be right there. In this case, it's 25 newton meters plus 5. So just look out for that if you don't have a workshop manual or similar and you need the torque spec. Now that we've got the filter in the engine, we are going to extract the old oil. There are two reasons why we change the filter first. When you remove the filter housing cap, it breaks the seal in the filter housing, and any oil that's in the housing is going to drain back into the crankcase. Also, in order to build a vacuum in the system to extract the oil, we need it to be semi-sealed. So we need the filter and we need the cap on the engine. We're going to get started with the extraction now. Okay, so here's your dipstick, bright yellow cap. You're just going to pull up, nothing to it. Things to keep in mind: if the dipstick is already up, you might have some crankcase pressure building up and you might want to investigate why that's happening. So it could be that, or it could simply be the O-ring on the dipstick has perished. In this case, everything looks good. We're just going to pull it up. I got a nice clean cloth here. I'm just going to set it down here. Regardless of where you set it down, always clean that dipstick before it goes back in the crankcase, because you don't want any dirt or anything from the outside ending up in the engine where it doesn't belong. Next thing we're going to do is we are going to shove the extraction hole into the sump until we hit the bottom. So you've got, and the same deal applies here. This hose that we're sticking into the engine, we want to make sure it's clean. I'm using one of the hard lines. The CTA extractor comes with a set of hard lines and soft lines of various sizes. This is the longest hard one. So I'm just going to shove that in. I feel like I've hit the bottom. I'm just going to put this onto the extractor. It's got a rubber O-ring to seal. All right, so to begin extracting, you're going to start pumping like this. If you hear air coming out like you're hearing right now, the valve is not in the correct position. Just go ahead and close it and then begin pumping. Give it about 5 pumps to start. And as you can see, the oil is going through the extraction hose, and you can step away. What I like to do while the oil is extracting is take a look at everything that's going on in my engine bay. So, as an example, we have reservoirs for the intercooler circuit, as well as for your radiator, your regular cooling circuit. Just go ahead and, you know, don't be afraid to open it up. So you're gonna crack it first to release the pressure if the engine's hot. Then open it up. Glance at the fluid level there. In this case, the color and the level is correct. We'll go ahead and close that up. Do the same for your intercooler over here. Just take a glance, make sure that fluid's in there and it's the right color. It's like a pinkish color. Close it right back. If this is the second or third oil change you're doing, you should also be considering changing your engine air filter. Very simple once you've already gotten the snorkel removed. There's one screw here, two here, and the electrical connector for the temperature sensor. Just remove that, the box comes right off, and you can change the engine air filter. Other things to look at while you're in here, especially as the seasons change, just get a little deeper down here where you have your serpentine belt. Check the condition of the belt. You can turn it, check for fraying, check for cracking. Just you want to take a look for any leaks that you might consider addressing the next time you can, or you might consider having a shop address. But while the oil is extracting, it's a great time to just take a look at what's going on in the engine bay. All right, so we've extracted the fluid from the crankcase. When it's at the point where it's about complete sucking out the fluid, you're going to see a large amount of air bubbles. You're going to hear air escaping, things like that. Those are all signs that it's just about done extracting the oil. Lastly, in the case of this motor, it's going to be between 6 and 6.5 liters of fluid that you're going to get out. In this case, we extracted the full 6.5 liters of fluid. Next thing that we're going to do is remove the extraction hose from the dipstick tube, get the air snorkel back on, and fill the engine with the 540 LIQUI MOLY. Another thing I want to mention while I'm removing the tube, if you're extracting fluid and you're starting to notice air bubbles and it doesn't seem as if it's extracting any more oil, but you're only like at 4 or 4.5 liters, you may just need to adjust the extraction hose in the tube. So just pull it up maybe about 1/4 inch or 1/2 inch. It might just be right at the base of the pan and it's having trouble sucking the oil up. But we're gonna remove this. There we are. We're gonna put this aside. We've got our dipstick here. Just wiping it down, making sure it's free of any dust particles. And then we're going to put it right back in. For our air snorkel, like I mentioned earlier, I'd like to remove this guy first from this end. I'm actually gonna put it back first on this end as well. Just line it up. Slip it in. Doing the same thing on the other side. And if this pickup point wasn't broken, I'd also make sure it slid into this and then turn the little locking mechanism over here. But we don't have that in this case. So air snorkel's back on. Now we're going to fill the engine up with the 540. So this is the LIQUI MOLY Lyclof high-tech 540. We're going to do about 6.25 liters of this fluid. Then we'll check the level at the dipstick, and we may have to top off after that. I have a pretty steady hand. If you don't, definitely look for the CTA European no-spill funnel that we have on the website. Really convenient way to just attach a funnel directly to the top of the valve cover, and you can just dump oil into the engine super quick. All right, so I'm just gonna wipe up around the lip here. If you have any spills, go ahead and just wipe it up. This rubber gasket has just been in the wrong position for so long that it has kind of taken the memory of the position it's in, so I'm just gonna leave that alone. Put that back on. I like to make sure that it's in this orientation. It can install that way or the other way and it'll be fine, but it just doesn't look right. Then lastly, we're gonna throw the cosmetic cover back on. We're gonna wait about 5 minutes for all the oil to drain back into the crankcase. Might even be less than that, and then we'll check the level at the dipstick. All right, so now I'm just checking the level to make sure I don't need to top things off. Just start by removing the dipstick. This is your max fill right there. As you can see, I'm right there, so I'm not going to be adding any more fluid. However, looking at the stick, you've got a couple of graduations from minimum. If you're not sure how much more oil you need to add, you can always consult the owner's manual. It'll let you know how much fluid from the min dot to the max dot is going to be required to get it back up to the correct level. In some cases, it's going to be a liter or 2 liters. It all depends on the application.
In order to reset the service indicator, make sure the instrument cluster is showing miles. Hold down the phone answer button and OK buttons on the steering wheel, and wait for the menu to appear where the last option displays Assist Plus. Select Assist Plus, then scroll down and select Service, then scroll down again and confirm Full Service. Select Yes for the oil grade, and then Confirm.
All right, so we have wrapped up our oil change on the C300, as I mentioned earlier. From about 2015 or 16 forward, the 300 variants have the 274 engine, and the procedure is going to be pretty much the same. However, if you have any questions, be sure to leave them in the comments below. If you like what you've seen today, like and subscribe. Thanks so much for watching.